Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade and welcome to another Coding Fundamentals and GML tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to talk about enums. An enum, you may remember from the Variable Basics tutorial, is a custom data type in GameMaker Studio 2. Essentially, it's a named integer that once created can be referenced anywhere in your code. In other words, you get to name a number and then use that name instead of using the number. Now, why is this useful? Let's assume that you have a player character with several states, and those states are idle, walk, and run. You have to represent those states somehow, and the normal way to do it would be with a number. However, saying player state equals 0 or player state equals 1 isn't particularly helpful when you're looking at your code later on. It really isn't helpful if you're giving your code to someone else. Enums are a way around that, because enums, again, allow you to name a number. Now you can say something like player state equals states.idle. And now it's obvious what the player state is. So enums are great because they allow you to have more readable code and more searchable code, and both of those things lead to more maintainable code. So before we give some examples of how to create and use enums, let's cover a couple rules about them. They can be created anywhere. So you can create them even in scripts that are never called. And a lot of people actually do this. They just create enum scripts where they list all their enums. I tend to create them in the create event of the object or parent of the object that is going to use those enums, but you can do it anywhere you want. The point again is that they can be created anywhere and they don't even need to be called in your code. And they're constants. You can't change them. So you can declare them and you can use them, but you can never modify them once you've declared them. So let's see some examples of enums. To make an enum, you use the keyword enum, followed by the general enum name, followed by each specific enum separated with a comma. You don't need to use a comma after the last enum, but you can. GameMaker will accept it either way. One important thing to know about enums is GameMaker gives them a default value. So if you don't specify something different, the first enum in the list will always be 0, and then it will increase by 1 going forward. So 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. If you want an enum to equal a certain number, you can set it directly with the equal sign, the same as you would for any variable. Name equals 0, amount equals 1. Again, remember though that enums can only be integers. Once you've created an enum, to use an enum, you simply use the general enum named, followed by a dot, followed by the specific enum. So player states dot idle. Again, you can see player states and then dot idle. You can say player states dot walk, player states dot run, player states dot attack. So player states dot idle. In this case, that would be the same as saying state equals 0 because player states dot idle is going to be 0 in this example. Or you could say item name equals inventory array, inventory slots dot name. Again, inventory slots dot name, and here we've specifically said that it will equal 0. So in summary, enums are a way of naming numbers, and then you can reference those names anywhere. And this helps create more readable, searchable, and maintainable code. As always, the links on this slide, as well as links to the slides and source code in general, will be below. That's it. Thanks for watching.